Hi, my name is Flemming Konradsen. I'm a professor of international environmental health here at the University of Copenhagen. Even as a student, I was interested in global issues and have been fortunate to study and work on different continents. Since I graduated with a degree in environmental health biology, I've worked for non-governmental organizations, universities, disease control programs, and international research organizations. Most of my work experience is from South Asia, East Africa, and Scandinavia. From very early on, I was really interested in understanding how our management of natural resources and environmental change at both community level and at greater scale impact the quality of life and population health. I also find it interesting to research the dynamics of specific diseases and how they are influenced by the environment, and also how entire ecosystems influence health of populations. It's fascinating and honestly sometimes scary to see how agricultural policies or urban planning can have significant positive or negative effects on people's lives, and how policies drafted in one country can impact on people's lives in other countries. As you may already know, global health spans many sectors, draws on methods, insights, traditions, and data from a large number of academic disciplines. Because of this, I'll not be teaching this course alone. In fact, I'll only be playing the main role in a small section, namely when we cover my own topic, environmental health. Instead, the course will be presented to you by a large number of researchers from different departments here at the University of Copenhagen. We have also included interviews with researchers and experts from institutions from around the world, as well as guest appearances by non-researchers. For instance, experts from some of the major international stakeholders in global health. Most global health issues hold the interest of many stakeholders, including UN agencies, governments, civil society, lobbyists, multinational businesses, and many more. It's my hope that this course will familiarize you with some of the most important players, as well as give you an understanding of the many different interests and opinions that shapes this field. Global health is seen by many as an expansion or evolution of tropical medicine, international health, international public health. Different organizations and scholars define global health in different ways. In this course, we are inspired by two different interpretations. One that defines global health as an area of study, research and practice that plays a priority on improving health and achieving health equity for all people worldwide. Another defines global health as those health issues that transcend national boundaries and governments and call for action on the global forces that determines the health of people. Global health may well include comparison of health status and programs across countries, but it's not limited to low or high income countries or particular geographical region of the world. During this particular course, we'll highlight important landmarks in the evolution of global health governance, including, for example, the establishment of the World Health Organization, the declaration of Alma-Ata on primary healthcare, the International Conference on Population and Development in Cairo in 1994, the health targets under the Millennium Development Goals, and of course, the significance of the Sustainable Development Goals for global health. Global health goes beyond medicine and health sciences and includes a great diversity of disciplines, such as political science, engineering, cultural studies, agriculture, and many more. Global health is truly a transdisciplinary area of work. And as the process of globalization continues, so must the way we address health issues. Pandemics, climate change and the protection of refugees are all examples of issues that can only be addressed by combining local, national and international action and governance. A global health perspective is also needed when addressing the opportunities and dilemmas linked with the globalization of the health profession. The expanding insurance and hospital businesses and increasing healthcare seeking across borders, sometimes referred to as medical tourism, Likewise, the increasing international travel will require improved surveillance and collaboration among national authorities to respond to the potential spread of infectious diseases. Also, the choices made by you as a consumer in one country may well influence the occupational health of workers on a different continent. Take as an example your own fridge. What you may find here represents a growing trade in agricultural products, creating employment to millions and servicing billions of consumers. It's also a good example of how pricing, standards, and competition may influence the health and opportunities for local farmers in countries where the products are produced. Equally, the growing trade in agricultural products calls for international standards to protect consumers against, for example, pesticide residues or the spread of drug-resistant strains of bacteria. Denmark, as other countries around the world, is influenced by international conventions that will impact on population health both here and at international level. For example, international trade agreements influence price and availability of products in the local supermarket, and the ratification of conventions may facilitate the passing of laws to control harmful substances such as tobacco. Just as we have seen the global development function as a potential catalyst for all sorts of health challenges, we also see new opportunities arise. One of them is technology, not only in better forms of treatment, new vaccines and medications, but also in information technology, which gives powerful tools for health promotion, awareness raising, and not least education of health professionals of the future. Across the world, you will find many different answers to the question, what is the greatest global health challenge? This may depend upon who you ask, how the problem is assessed, and clearly will reflect the huge global inequalities in health and access to healthcare. An inequality that is not only reflected across countries, but clearly also among groups living within the same countries. In the past decade, the world has seen significant progress in human health, especially in relation to control of infectious diseases. Life expectancy has increased, fertility rates have dropped, and the quality of life improved for millions. Similarly, increased school enrollment has provided an important basis for health promotion and influenced one of the most important social determinants of health. However, in spite of the progress made, the world still hosts millions of people living in extreme poverty, lacking even the most basic amenities such as water and sanitation. Poverty, malnutrition, infectious disease, and diseases and reproductive health are still fundamentals of an unfinished global agenda. Some people are faced with war and conflict, directly as refugees or indirectly as hosting communities. Others live in areas without functioning health system or have no access to affordable treatment. At the same time, the aging population, urbanization, changing diets are among the drivers of an epidemic of non-communicable diseases, such as cancer and diabetes, felt by rich and poor. An epidemic rise in non-communicable diseases that requires lifelong chronic treatment and fundamental changes to the way we think of prevention and healthcare. Add to this an increasing burden from mental health issues, and it's clear that all sectors of society need to address the potential downside of global megatrends. This course will enable you to take part in the global discussion and link everyday headlines of epidemics, trade agreements, conflicts, or economic issues to the essential question of life and death, health and disease of millions. We really look forward to your opinions and your perspectives on these issues. We also aim to point towards key resources for future references and study. We'll discuss global health governance and identify the role of key actors. We'll aim to provide you with an overview of the most important global health problems that transcends the perspectives of individual countries. Welcome to the course. I'm looking forward to seeing you online. Thank you very much.